Bianca. Your Uncle Jack feels that we shouldn't make any concrete decisions right now. That we should wait until things calm down. Okay. Oh, no, wait a second. I'm not finished. I agree with him. So, I propose that you come with me tomorrow just to visit the school that I have in mind, and you can tell me your decision, and I promise I will keep an open mind about it.
I guess I could check it out.
Oh, sweetheart. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, honey. This has been a very long day. I'm going to go upstairs to bed.
Okay, Mom. I actually wouldn't mind heading out to SOS for a while. Are you up for it, Leah?
Yeah.
Are you sure? Aren't you tired?
I need to clear my head for a little while. I won't be out late. Are you ready, Leo?
Sure. Don't worry, I know the drill.
All right, so how'd I do?
That was much, much better. And believe me, I know it practically killed you to see her walk out that door.
Yes, well, don't let it stop you from leaving. Good night, Jack.
Well, before the doorknob hits me in my rather ample behind, there was one thing I wanted to talk to you about while Bianca's gone. Something that Barbara brought up. Frankly, I'd discounted it until now.
What, about Bianca?
Yeah.
Well, of course. Well, sit down. Tell me. What is it?
When we were in Seattle, I asked Barbara what caused the rift between her and Bianca.
Oh, as if I'd ever believe a word that Barbara has
to
say.
You want to hear this or not?
All right, go ahead.
Thank you.
Wait a second. Why are you just bringing this up now?
Because you and Bianca have been at each other's throats since we left Seattle, and I just want to make sure that you don't inadvertently throw something in her face that's both very private and very painful.
What are you talking about?
Barbara said that when Bianca first came home from rehab, everything was fine, everything was great. And then she suddenly started to spend a lot of time on the computer, a lot of time doing emails.
That's it? Jack, kids are glued to the internet.
All hours of the day and night. There's some strange things going on out there, Erica. And so Barbara asked Bianca about it, and Bianca got very defensive then. When Barbara suggested that they put some limitations on the computer use, Bianca got withdrawn, very uncommunicative, and Barbara got so worried she called Bianca's rehab counselor.
Trudy.
That's right, Trudy. And she asked her if she could possibly have met someone that she was continuing to communicate with after rehab.
What did Trudy say?
Trudy said she had no idea. But just about that time, Bianca quit going on the computer totally and shut herself down completely. Now, Barbara thinks that Bianca met a boy in rehab, fell in love, and they kept the relationship going on the computer afterwards. And then they broke up.
Oh, my God. So that's it. My daughter's had her heart broken. Why didn't I think of that? Of course, Jack, it all fits. I mean, first love is so intense. I mean, I wish I could protect her from the pain. Better yet, I wish I could find the guy who broke up with her and just, you know, wring his neck.
Yeah, I know how you feel. When Barbara told me about this, I thought maybe I should go out and find this boy and neuter him myself.
Well, at least now we know, you know, what's been bothering Bianca and why she's been acting so strangely. Oh, poor baby. Poor baby. I know what that pain is like, and I just, you know, I was worried about her because I could see her self-esteem going down and down, and then that boy broke up with her like that, of course, and now Travis dying.
I know that look. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking that I cannot, of course, protect my daughter from heartache, but as her mother, I can sure make her feel better about herself, and that's exactly what I intend to do.
Have a good time?
Yeah.
You guys enjoy it?
Oh, yeah.
I love BB Mac.
Yeah? You want to meet him? Come on.
I don't know.
Come on, go
the table.
Come on.
Hey, guys, I want you to meet somebody. This is Bianca Montgomery. This is Christian, Mark, and Steve.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Christian.
Hi, Christian.
Nice to meet you.
You guys are really awesome.
Thank you very much. Have you got any requests for the next set?
Oh, yeah, tons.
Did you get a hold of your mother?
Yeah, I told her that we'd be hanging out here for a little while longer.
Did she give you a hassle?
She wasn't thrilled, but she didn't force me to come home.
Cool.
You know, Leo, you've helped me through the worst week of my life.
It's nice to be needed.
You've been a really good friend. So, let me return the favor.
No, we're here. It's happening.
I'm not so caught up in my own drama that I can't see that you're thinking about something or someone. Is it Greenleaf?
Yeah. I just tried to call her and she basically blew me off.
Why?
I don't know. I'm not sure, but it's a pretty safe bet that it involves Ryan Lavery.
System.
Labor's not the only problem. It's the endless games.
So what? Do you want to call it a night?
Sure. You up to facing your mom?
I think I might just stick around here for a while.
That's fine.
I'll take a cab home.
That's fine. I can stay.
Quick, call the exposer. Erica Kane's daughter behind the eight ball. Wouldn't
right.
My mom love that?
All right, I hear you. But you're sure you're all right here?
Yeah, fine. What about you? Okay about Greenlee?
Are you kidding me? Greenlee doesn't know what she's missing, Bianca. Watch out. I'll talk to you later. We belong together.
Bianca Jagger?
Actually, just my luck. My mom was going through her Shakespeare phase when I was born. I guess I should be happy I'm not a Desdemona.
Oh
my gosh. You're never, you cut class all the time. Where's
she going?
Shakespeare what?